Hello, I'm Teresa Hansen, Vice President of Global Content for Clarion Energy. Welcome to this week's edition of Clarion Energy News. Here are the stories. Story number one. While nuclear power generation is declining in some countries, a new report by the World Nuclear Association says global nuclear generation increased in 2018 for the sixth straight year. According to the report, reactors worldwide produced more than 2,500 terawatt hours of electricity in 2018, which is about 10% of worldwide demand. The increase was most dramatic in Asia, where nuclear generation increased by nearly 12% to 533 terawatt hours. Globally, 9 new reactors began generating electricity last year, while 5 reactors turned 50 years old. In the U.S., no nuclear generation has been added in many years, and several sites have been closed or planned for closure due to cost and political pressures. However, several utilities plan to ask the U.S. Nuclear Regulatory Commission to extend licenses and keep many plants operating. Story number two. President Donald Trump said he is not willing to sacrifice the abundant fossil energy wealth of the U.S. on dreams such as renewable power. This is according to a recent Bloomberg article. President Trump made the comments when asked about climate change at the end of the G7 summit that took place in France the week of August 26th. Trump addressed the issue of climate change by citing the United States' surging exports of both crude oil and natural gas. President Trump said such energy development has enriched the U.S. The president has a history of downgrading renewable energy, especially wind power, and is a strong proponent of fossil fuels. He did not personally attend the climate change session at the G7 summit, but it was reported that other White House officials did attend the session. Story number three. Hydro Tasmania is accelerating the detailed investigation of 3 key opportunities for pumped hydro storage development in the state. The assessments will involve community engagement, geotechnical investigations, and environmental, heritage, and social assessments. The development of pumped storage is part of Australia's Battery of the Nation initiative. Kane Thornton, chief executive of the Clean Energy Council, which is Australia's primary renewable energy association, welcomed the announcement. Thornton said that Australia will be completely powered by renewable energy at some point in the next few decades, and that Tasmania's hydropower would play a critical role in supporting that transition. Early modeling shows unlocking Tasmania's renewable energy potential could generate billions of dollars of investments and thousands of jobs. Before I sign off, I want to give you a couple of important updates about Clarion Energy's North American Power and Energy events. First, PowerGen International has, to date, secured nearly 35 speakers from various utilities and power generation companies to speak. They will be featured in both the Summit and Knowledge Hub sessions in New Orleans on November 19th through the 21st. If you're in the business of generating power, you should be at this event to network and learn from your peers. You can find all the details, including registration information, at power-gen.com. Secondly, Hydrovision International has extended its call for abstracts deadline to September 4th. So, if you're interested in speaking at our Hydro Power Show next summer, you still have time to submit an abstract. You can find all the details about this opportunity at hydroevent.com. That's it for this week's edition of Clarion Energy News. I'm Teresa Hansen. Thanks for watching.